Okay guys, here is my indoor catfish aquaponics system. Okay, so I'm going to do a little update here on my channel catfish that I've got in the fish tank here. These guys are supposed to go outside into the aquaponics system that's in the greenhouse. However, if you've been following, you know that the greenhouse is not done yet and I still got a ways to go. So anyway, I've got a little indoor aquaponics system type deal going on here. This is just nothing but a lid. That's the lid to this styrofoam cooler. $3 at Walmart for the whole thing. And basically I just poked some holes in it, and I had some onion chives that they fit perfectly in there, but they kind of ran their course. These, I think they're called pothos. Basically it's just some houseplant that we got. We pulled some feeders off of that one, put them in here. No root compound, no nothing, just plucked it and put it in there. And seems like the roots are going pretty good. So we had this avocado pit. Anyway, it's looking pretty happy in this water. Okay, so it took straight up 12 weeks, almost to the day, before the tank cycled itself. I lost quite a few fish, but I've learned a lot about just the cycling process itself. Plus, I've had time to watch these fish and just watch their behavior. So even though I got the fish before I was ready to put these fish in the system that I have not built yet in my greenhouse outside that still isn't finished, I've learned a lot just by watching these guys. These fish cycled this water, so there was a lot of time that they went without regular feeding, so I don't know that I might have stunted their growth. That is a possibility. The fish went for a long time without feeding, so now that everything's cleared up, all my levels are reading zero as far as ammonia, nitrites, and nitrates. So now I'm at a good point where I'm going to start keeping track of what I'm feeding them day by day. Because okay, we calibrated at zero. Let's see how much these fish weigh. 7. This is the smallest one. That's the guy that weighs 7 grams. I think 7 grams is probably pretty close to what these other guys are doing. I've weighed 2 fish. One is at 7 grams, the other one looks like it's at 3 grams. A 3 gram fish is definitely by far the smallest fish in the tank. Once I do the numbers, it comes out to 2.52 grams of food per day that I should be feeding these fish. The most that I have fed them in the last week is I've been weighing out 1 gram and then kind of just giving them about 0.5 gram a day just to slowly introduce food back into the system. I'm gonna work my way up to 2.5 grams. So about 2 weeks ago, I started getting this buildup on the sides of the tank. I've gone in there and wiped it off like 2 times and it just started coming back. So about 3 days ago, we got some albino plecostomus. There's one right there behind the filter. It's kind of hard to see it. They cleaned up this part of the wall real good in just a few hours. The sun that we get, you know, just a little bit of sun, I mean, it's enough sun to where it's causing a problem, but I think now that we got the plecos in there, that they will keep it under control. This is nothing to take too seriously, but I'm just gonna play around with it and see what I can do. So anyway guys, at this point, I'm gonna start feeding these fish and working my way up to 2.5 grams. I'm gonna try and probably get some herbs or something that can grow in here, some basil or something, I don't know. But next couple of days I'm gonna try and get something else going in here. And I'll keep you posted.